GPS is a navigation system based on 24 satellites that orbit the Earth. They are owned by the United States government and were originally for military purposes, but they were made available to the public around the year 2000. Each satellite sends a signal back to the Earth, but they cannot pass through solid objects like mountains and buildings. They're also less accurate around trees. The GPS unit I have here is a Garmin E-Trex 20. First, I've got to turn the GPS on. I push this button here, and it takes a little while to load, so we'll just wait. Then the unit will begin searching for satellite signals. The GPS receiver must lock in at least 3 signals to work. The more signals you get, the more accurate your position. Each satellite has a number representing a specific satellite in space. The satellites in the middle of the bullseye are much closer to you than the satellites outside the bullseye. As the GPS acquires signals, the strength of each signal is represented by the bars on the bar graph at the bottom of the screen. If you got white bars, it would mean that the GPS is still trying to get the signal. But we have orange bars, which means that the GPS has already acquired the signal. Tall bars show stronger signals than short bars. In this case, we've got many tall bars, therefore this side's got a pretty good signal. When the GPS has at least 3 signals, your latitude and longitude coordinates appear at the top of the screen. In the top right, you can see how accurate your signal is. Here you can see that the signal is accurate to within 3 meters. The GPS has many other useful functions, including a stopwatch, a trip computer page. Now on this trip computer page, you can also see that the GPS has an altimeter. You can see here where the elevation of 314 meters above sea level. The GPS also has area measurement, a calculator, alarm, map, compass, and so on. Okay, what I'm doing here is I've just wandered out into the middle of the stream here because I want to demonstrate the impact that an overhanging ledge might have on the signal of the GPS. Now when I push the satellite search, it takes a little bit longer to acquire the signals. I see the more of the white bars here, that mean the GPS is still trying to find the signal. Now I have acquired a signal now, but it just took a bit longer than it did in the previous site. So as I said before, when you're near tall buildings or really big trees or rocks, you may lose the signal altogether. So all you got to do is you got to move somewhere else until you find a signal. Today I want to focus on marking waypoints, which is simply the location you want to reach. I'm starting here by the Whirinaki River, which is not far from the Whirinaki Forest Park in the North Island of New Zealand. I'm going to mark this point here as my waypoint, then I'm going to show you how I can get myself lost somewhere in a paddock nearby and then use my GPS to find my way back. Now I'm at my new location, I want to find my way back. So I'm going to go onto the map here. And you can see where I am on the map, but we need to change the scale somewhat so we can see clearer. So you got these arrows just on the left hand side of the GPS. And you can alter the scale. So I've just gone from 2 kilometers out. And I'm going to come to about 80 meters. Now the GPS will show me how to get back to my waypoint in a straight line. You can see this pink straight line down the bottom of the screen here.
It does not take into account features I need to avoid, like obstacles such as streams or impenetrable forest. The arrow here shows where I am now, and the straight line shows the location of where I started. The good news is, as I change direction, the orientation of that line will also change position, so I still know the overall direction I need to be heading. And here I am, the GPS has just signaled to me that I have arrived. We're back at the beautiful stream where I began.